Coming up, I will walk you through the latest update management capabilities for Windows and Linux as part of the new automation and control service in Azure. We'll show you how this gives you visibility and control of updates across your hybrid environments, and how you can now deploy software updates with respect to your defined maintenance windows. If you're using multiple tools and processes today to manage your on-premises, Azure, and third-party cloud environments, the new automation and control service now gives you a unified view of updates and compliance across your IT infrastructure. If I go into the update management solution, you can see now that we give a unified view across your Windows and Linux environment. You can see that we give reporting across all the computers under management and which ones might be missing critical, security, or other type of updates. Similarly, we give you a compliance view so you can identify computers that may not be updated in your compliance window. But this is not just for Windows, we also give you Linux, so you can see all your computers under management for Linux, as well as which ones might be missing critical security or other updates. And if you want to find out which ones are missing specific classifications, we also group those together so you can zero in on just your security updates, critical updates, or update rollups. If I drill down into one of these, you can see that all of this information is built upon the powerful log search capabilities we have in Azure. And so what this allows you to do is to quickly identify which ones you want to go and update. So here I'm clicking on security updates. And so now I can just see all of the updates that are related to security. If I go into the list view, I can get detailed information about the computer, the update, what type of product we're targeting. And if I want to find more information about the knowledge base article, I can click on view. And that brings me to the full knowledge base article provided by Microsoft for this update. Now, let's explore another common challenge, the management and deployment of updates within your defined maintenance window. With the new Azure Automation and Control Service, you can now deploy updates across your hybrid environments, all within your defined maintenance window. This ensures that you can keep compliant with your servicing SLAs. If I click into Manage Update Deployments, you can now see that I have visibility all into all the scheduled updates that I've created earlier, any that are currently running, as well as ones that are completed, so I could troubleshoot any failures that occur. If I want to deploy a new update, I can click on Add, and this allows me to select specific computers I want to be part of this update deployment, any saved groups that I've created during that search experience that I want to deploy, previous update runs that I've created I can also select, as well as any WSUS groups or Active Directory groups that I want to target as part of this update deployment. We also have rich scheduling capabilities available. So we support one-time scheduling. You can also do a weekly schedule. And we allow you to do recurring monthly. So you might want to specify to run this on the last Friday of every month. A key capability we also offer is the ability to specify your maintenance window. So this ensures that all of your updates will actually get installed during your SLA, and any remaining updates will get deployed during the next update run. So what I've shown you today is how you can monitor and get insights easily across your environments and deploy software updates within your maintenance window. Our goal is to deliver unified update management across Azure and your on-premises environments for both Windows and Linux. You will continue to see investments in this area as we deliver this experience native in the Azure portal, as well as add core capabilities like orchestration and approvals. Please visit the link below to get started with the update management capabilities in the automation and control service in Azure. Thanks for watching.